the crosses you are very familiar with is this particular St. Bridget's cross, and some of you wove them. Did you try weaving some of these other ones? Those of you who wove them now, you get the chance to. This is a traditional one. These three crosses are also found woven in different parts of Ireland. This one they know as the Trinity Cross in Donegal. This was only the person playing with brushes, but maybe it was originally a pre-Christian symbol that came into Christianity, because the story associated with Brigid at the cross is that sitting by a chieftain, she started weaving a cross probably from the rushes that were on the floor, and he woke up and he was watching her and asked her what she was doing, and she said she was weaving a cross, and he wanted to know what was a cross. And the story says that Brigid went on to talk about the life, death, and resurrection of Christ, and about the encompassing love for all, and he wants to know that that included him too. So that's the story associated with the cross. And then there's a lovely, we often weave crosses. When we were turning the sod for our centre here, we wove the Brigid's cross as part of the ritual of the turning of the sod. And then when we laid the foundations, we put the sod into the foundations of the building. And the other thing associated with Brigid's cross, if people had a falling out during the year, on St. Brigid's Day, if they handed the St. Brigid's cross, it was a symbol of reconciliation and starting, forgiveness and starting again. And people still do put the crosses into the foundations of their houses. And there's a lovely little blessing that goes with it. May Brigid bless the house where you dwell. Bless every fireside, every wall and floor. Bless every heart that beats beneath its roof. Bless every hand that toils to bring it joy. Bless every foot that walks its portals through. May Brigid bless the house that shelters you. So I think that little blessing goes with the cross, and people then put them in their houses, and they put them in the outhouses as well. For protection for the animals, because Brigid was in the animals. The other story about the cross, and we just said this before we moved to the other room, is in 2013, our government, to invite, boost the economy, they invited the diaspora to come back to Ireland. And there was little festivals in every town, and we ran one here as part of the organising group that ran a little festival as well. And the key point of the festival we decided was to try and set a world record. We needed St. Bridget's crosses. And in the 21st of September in 2013, 365 people gathered in St. Bridget's Catholic Church. And at the end of it, we had 357 recognisable St. Bridget's crosses. And as somebody said at the beginning of it, what's a recognisable St. Bridget's cross? It has a centre and it has four. it didn't examine too closely the centre, but most people, because most people learned to weave the crosses beforehand, and that's what we wanted it to happen. And it was a lovely reflective day, and people proudly had their little crosses. And about 3 months later, we got the notification from the World Record Games. We were officially amazing, so we had made it.
Right. And we actually set the record because they had to set, so they set it for us, you know, so now it's up to somebody else to come
and
yeah. We won't betray it.
No, it was a lot of hard work. They're very strict on all the ritual around.
Even the length of the rush and how long they were so
And this is what